Welcome to Your Future Is Now, hosted by Jim Grant and Bill Heinrich. Their show is dedicated to sharing information in business, health, and obstacles we face in our everyday lives. Jim is also the TV host of Messages of Inspiration and Hope on E360 TV. Bill is the author of 7 Levels of Truth and is a master in the world of getting clarity in your mind to clear out the cobwebs and remove mental barriers that hold you back. Each week, they will interview an exciting guest. We're so glad you've tuned in. Be sure to share the show. And now, here's Jim.
Well, thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. We appreciate you tuning in today. Your Future Is Now is proudly brought to you by the good guys at the 6MinuteWebinar.com. And here on the Toganet Radio Station, I am joined by one of the honorary hosts here on Toganet, Mr. Bill Heinrich. Bill is the author of the 7 Levels of Truth, as you heard in the opening. He also has a free ebook that you can download, and it comes directly to your inbox. It's called Clarity Has No Story, 3 Simple Words, myfreebook.me. M is in Mike, E is in Echo. And today's guest is Mr. Joel Peterson that we have. We're going to be talking today about a subject that's not really, you know, people don't want to talk much about it. It's about suicide. I got my tongue tied there for a second because suicide is such a horrible word. I've experienced that in my immediate family, and I know the pain and the guilt and everything associated with that. But we're going to hear how Joel Peterson is talking to medical doctors about their suicide rate and how this is more physical than it is mental. How about that? And Mr. Bill Heinrich, welcome to the show, my man. So glad to have you here.
Well, I'm glad to be here again and really happy to have Joel on today. And we're going to be doing, you know, with the 6-minute webinar, we're going to be doing another boot camp next Saturday. And if somebody has an interest, you can go to www.6minutewebinar.com/bootcamp. And you can get all the information. We do a 3-hour live interaction, interactive boot camp with the participants, Don McGrath and I, who co-created the 6-minute webinar. And if you want to get some clarity in your life or in your business, this is the place to be.
Mm-hmm. We got a little bit of background noise there, ladies and gentlemen. Apologize for that. But yes, that 6-minute webinar, that's SIXMinuteWebinar.com. You really need to go there and check it out, /bootcamp, and you will be glad that you did. And I'm going to go ahead and welcome Joel Peterson to the stage. I don't know where the background noise is coming in. It sounds like someone's moving or something. So anyway, Joel, welcome to the show, my man.
Thank you, Jim and Bill. I'm absolutely honored, and it's a pleasure to be here.
Well, thank you very much. And in the opening comments, I made the comments about suicide. And goodness gracious, that is a horrible word. I experienced that in my life, in my family. My son-in-law, who suffered from CTE, chronic traumatic encephalopathy, he shot himself. And so, you know, when you talk about how painful that is for people to deal with and live with. I mean, it's anyone that's experienced that, they know the guilt, they know the pain. But your subject today and what you're going to be talking about in your topic is that we've always believed it was something mental. And you're really opening up some minds, aren't you, sir?
Yes, Jim. I have the fortunate luck and foreseeing of working with DOs, Doctors of Osteopathic Medicine. And we're getting ready for our 49th American Osteopathic Society of Rheumatic Diseases and our Integrative Health Alliance annual conference. And I call myself the professional patient because all my life I've been dealing with disability. And my own suicidal thoughts. And I had them so much, I thought they were normal. I thought it was part of what everybody thought about. And in 2014, I started to get sick. 2015, I was dying. And I'm reaching out to the VA and having a hard time with the VA. And they literally said that this is in your head. You're okay. Quit stressing. And you need to eat more. And it got so critical. I got down to 135 to 137 pounds. And my mother had to move in with me and feed me by hand just to keep me alive.
Wow.
And this was where I reached out to a local DO, and he started to do acupuncture and bioidentical hormone therapy on me. And this is what changed my life. And this was in 2015. And this is what set me on the path of entrepreneurship in the realm of suicidology and suicide solutions.
Yeah. So you started out, you've definitely got skin in the game because you're a veteran too. And you served in, was it U.S. Army you served in?
I was a United States Marine.
Marines. I stand corrected.
Yeah, hoorah. I got out just before Desert Storm started.
I see. Yeah. Because our producer, Ben here, Ben Horlander here on TokenEd, he's also a former Marine. Notice I said former Marine because that is the respectful way you refer to someone that has served in the Marine Corps. And that's an old Army guy like me. But, you know, Joel, you had skin in the game. You had that. You know how it feels when you're faced with suicidal tendencies. You know what it's like to have your health failing, your mind failing, everything. You're kind of like in a critical downfall, aren't you?
Yes. And, you know, Tony Robbins calls it a state of mind. And we're starting to learn that this state of mind, this state of being, this state of your energy is controlled by food, controlled by community, controlled by art and hobbies, controlled by your environment. And when you start to get into this sickness, you start to believe that you're mental. You start to believe that your depression is who and what you are. And so the first reaction is, oh, Lord, now I got to go to mental health because I'm crazy, because I'm mental. We're not taught to think that this could be a gut problem or a heart problem, a physical problem. And that's what I started to learn with these doctors of osteopathic medicine and naturopathic medicine and acupuncture and chiropractor and food and some of the scientists we have out now. They're starting to learn about the neurites in our heart and our gut. And so our gut and our heart communicate to the brain, not the other way around. So our perception of pain, for instance, when you're in pain, especially chronic pain that cannot be figured out or dealt with medications, people do end up succumbing to suicide. But then you have a perception of pain and a belief of pain. So let's say you get tangled up with the mafia and you know they're going to come in and they're going to kill you or they're going to beat you down. You've got this perception of pain and it's a belief, but you don't know if it's actually going to happen yet. So this thing is starting to happen with our veterans coming back from war, but not necessarily combat. They have a perception and a belief of this mental health, and they're going to be this way the rest of their life because they start to get sick. And there's multiple reasons why they get sick. That's up to the doctors to figure that out. And then we're now starting to learn that our doctors are killing themselves at a greater rate than veterans. We believe it's roughly 40 per 100,000. And our veterans are right around anywhere from 27 to 30 per 100,000. And civilians are at 13 to 15 per 100,000. So it's gotten out of control, in my opinion.
Bill, I tell you what, that's some of the things he's sharing there is really shocking, isn't it?
It really is. It really is. You know, Joel, what are some of the things that you're doing to educate people?
We're starting to teach them about how important hydration is, how important breathing is, how important proper food. and organic food is, proper supplementation, proper elimination, because there is a awful lot of poisons and toxins in our environment now. And staying away from politics and the whys and the wows and all that, it doesn't matter nowadays who you are. You could be a top-of-the-line athlete, and you still have to eliminate poisons and toxins, and you've got to buy the same organic food that a lot of us have to buy. We really believe that's one of the keys. And then reaching out to your community, your churches, and having a mission, having a passion. Like these doctors, they'll wake up, they'll get their morning coffee, they'll go to work, they'll do their job, they'll come home, they might watch a little TV, they'll drink a little wine or beer, go to bed. If you're not writing a book, if you're not involved in webinars or seminars or these conferences, if you're not volunteering in your community, you're stuck in a rut. And so I help people get out of these ruts and recognize they're in a rut and recognize you have to get out of yourself and not just be slave to your industry, slave to your job. And that's one of my specialties that I'm learning.
Fascinating. Go ahead, Jim.
I was just going to say, we had Dr. George Grant on our TV show. He's real big on natural health. He's a professor. He's got 3 doctorate degrees. And he said the very same thing you did about how important it is to breathe properly and drink plenty of water. That is the foundation of all health. And Dr. George Grant he's on the Messages of Inspiration and Hope YouTube channel. And goodness, you guys would have a conversation that is on the chart. In fact, I'd like to schedule both of you to be on the show together, the TV show, and discuss that in further detail. We're about 15 seconds out from going, to a commercial break. But I tell you what, Bill, I can't wait to come back and hear more about what Joel's got to say. How about you, brother?
Oh, absolutely. I want to hear, I want to talk more about the organic food and diet portion of it.
Okay.
Yeah, absolutely. And we'll do that, folks, because you're getting ready to go to break here, and we'll be right back right after these messages.
SpeakersPathway.com is the proud sponsor of Your Future Is Now, a show dedicated and aligned in perfect harmony with the vision and mission of Speakers Pathway. Dr. Sony Jackson's expertise is on the art of marketing while cultivating a long-term customer relationship in your business world. Do you know what to say or how to deliver your message to complete strangers? If so, Sony can help you. Tamara Hunter is a cancer survivor and works with people to focus their message or mission to the audience they want to reach. Do you feel called to create a movement to make the world a better place? If so, Tamara can help you. For additional information from any of our executive training directors, go to speakerspathway.com. That is speakerspathway.com.
Hear the one about the man who drove his van into a lake because he was following GPS instructions. The minivan driver apparently ignored a series of road signs while following his GPS, which directed him to an abandoned road which led right into a lake. What's a word for a person who obeys without question? A myrmidon. His vehicle was almost entirely underwater by the time emergency services arrived on the scene. Police said the driver took a road that was closed a year ago when the area was flooded to make an artificial lake to serve as a reservoir. He ignored 3 road signs warning of a dead end. It was dark outside and simply didn't see the water. Sounds like a bit of a rinkaboo to me. That's a news story that may be bending the truth a little. It's marching. I'm Carolyn Davidson, and you can have fun challenging your words you never heard vocabulary with my free app, Too Funny for Word.
And welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Your Future Is Now is proudly sponsored by the good guys at the 6MinuteWebinar.com. I'm joined today by an honorary host here on the Toganet radio station, Mr. Bill Heinrich. Bill is not only the co-creator of the 6-Minute Webinar, he also has a free ebook he'd like to give you called Clarity Has No Story. Just go to myfreebook.me. Myfreebook.me, M as in Mike, E as in Echo, and he'll send that thing right to your inbox in a hurry. He's quicker than grease lightning. Mr. Bill, I tell you, Joel is really going to, he's already started out on some great information. We're going to get a little bit deeper into nutrition. Is that right, sir?
Yeah, I've really got some questions in that area. And anyone listening in,
yeah,
let me just add this to this conversation. I've known Joel for a few years now, and he is so committed to getting this word out and making a difference. It's and the amount of growth you've had, Joel, and the work that you're doing is astonishing to me. Congratulations. It's just amazing.
Thank you, Bill, very much.
Yeah, you're a true inspiration, really. You show up, you do it, you're learning all kinds of new things. So I really want to commend you on that. So let's talk about diet. Let's talk about the organic food specifically.
Okay. I learned this also with Dr. Nelson. And what I'm realizing is we have a long, quote-unquote, lifespan. And you hear about the discrepancies and the differentiation between vegans, vegetarian, and meat eaters. And you got paleo and keto, and you got all this stuff, right? Well, what's wrong with cutting out dairy and meat for a little while to clean yourself up if you believe you're sick? Then you throw in corn, you throw in soy, you throw in wheat and grains, which quite a few of them are sprayed with a lot of Roundup and a lot of other poisons that they don't even have to list or put down. So they're tearing up the gut. And once you start tearing up the gut, it really gets critical. And your energy gets really messed up in a body. So I believe that going to organic minimizes the poisons and minimizes the toxins. And we get a lot of poisons and toxins from toothpaste, from deodorants, from water, from the air, things we put on our body. It adds up. It adds up. And certain aluminums and metals, they have half-lives of years. So it can take a long time for this stuff to get out. And there's processes, saunas, mud baths, foot detox, hand detox. But pharmacological corporations, and some of the politics involved, they more or less want us to go for pills. We're starting to realize that now. And people worldwide are starting to realize that now. And now we see how powerful food is. So getting to organic food, and it's sad that we even have to go there, to be quite honest. We shouldn't have genetically modified. You think about sugar. I use sugar as an example. Why did we have to genetically modify a beet and then turn it into a genetically modified sugar? Were we low in sugar? No. It's because they wanted profit. And then the body doesn't recognize this type of sugar. And it's not from a sugar cane. It's not, quote unquote, naturally made. So why'd we go to that level of syntheticism for food? And it's harming us tremendously, Bill.
Yeah, that's really, really amazing what they've done. I saw a thing on the pesticides, you know, the farmers now, the seeds they get when they get shipped to them, Joel, have to be marked as pesticides.
Correct. Poison.
Yeah, because they have them, Monsanto and the other companies have built the weed killers and everything right into them.
Yeah, and they,
quite remarkable.
There's a couple of YouTube videos out. One is called Food Choices, and the other is Food Incorporated. They explain it quite well. And these corporations have the farmers really tied up and afraid. And I believe it's going to be one of the ways we take back our food and our health is to deal with these corporations that have gotten too big for their britches, as many would say. That's it in a nutshell. And it's sickening our kids. It's sickening our people. And now I hear 10 to 24-year-olds, the number one cause of death in the United States of America for them is now suicide. So not just our doctors are killing themselves, our veterans are killing themselves. And we believe up to 144,000 veterans have now succumbed to suicide in the past 20 years. And that's going off of their numbers. And we're almost all positive that the numbers are low. So we could be over 200,000 deaths now in 20 years. And as a comparison to Vietnam, we lost a little over 56,000 in combat in Vietnam. So that's that gives you an idea of what's going on with this horrendous death of suicide from these two wars.
Well, I tell people all the time that we must remember that our body is a processing center. It is not a recycling center, because that's what's got to be done with all these harmful metals and things and poisons that's been in our food without our knowledge, without our consent. And we have to be proactive about it. We have to be educated about it. And we got to realize that some of these real big companies, their focus is profit over people any day of the week. I'm not trying to be negative. I'm just saying I'm sick and tired of the nonsense that's going on, because it's harming a lot of people's health.
Agree. And it's like government. People don't realize, like Apple per se, there's a lot of CEOs in Apple. There's a lot of states. There's a lot of countries that have Apple. So when you look at Apple as one corporation, it's a huge corporation. It's not like there's one person at top overseeing everything. So you've got a lot of special interest involved. And this is where governments and corporations get out of control, and people want their profit. And people who support and sponsor these businesses, they want their dividends, they want their stocks. And so it all gets lost in the wash. Mm-hmm. In the meantime, we're down here on the street killing ourselves. We're down here catching the autism or the Alzheimer's or the diabetes. And it's just, it's really gotten so out of control that we're now the most developed, sickest country on earth. And we're second or third for obesity. So it's just, it's horrific what's going on. And you can see it in our doctors, our veterans, our active duty, and our youth.
Let me ask you a question. The situation we're in, we're all aware of it. And, you know, we realize what the problem is. But starting from the individual, the person out there that says, I'm tired of playing this game, I want to walk to the beat of my own drum, how can they start turn their life around and start improving their health? What are some of the things that you have found there, Joel?
You know, if you're suicidal, if you're depressed, if you've got anxiety, then that means that the process and the system you have in place right now is not working. Mm-hmm. So it means you need a new process, possibly a new doctor and a new second opinion and new labs. I believe that's the start for most nowadays, because if you're suicidal, that means everything that you're doing, it hasn't worked. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times we get caught, like I said, in those ruts. So you just think you're depressed. You just think you're sad. It's because of money or it's because of no. When you really go get to a new private doctor or a new doctor at the hospital you're at and you have labs run, you'd be amazed what happens. And then you go from there. So if you're not getting results with where you're at, you've got to get a second opinion and get new results.
Mm-hmm.
That's one. Mm-hmm. Two would be to go to, two would be to work on your diet. A lot of us are absolutely allergic to dairy. And the way they're doing dairy nowadays, you have these hormones and antibiotics in there, and that's sickening us too. So that would be the two keys right off the bat.
I see you. I hear you. And because a lot of people are probably like me, they got more pesticides and metals in them than they even realize. They're, you know, the real health starts at the gut. That's what Dr. George Grant was talking about. So when it starts in the gut, that's where you got to start. And that's obviously from good food that's free of pesticides and the different poisons and metals and things that affect our body, because that's, our bodies were never designed to be like that. You know, and I tell you, you know, when we think about our lives and what's going on, you know, we got to start with our health. And, you know, there's so much I want to say here, and I'm trying to figure out which what I want to say here, because we only get, I'm getting notices from the producer. We only got 1 minute left, and he's keep tagging, which means 30 seconds and 15 seconds, you know. But anyway, you know, starting with eating right and drinking plenty of fresh water, not water from the regular, you know,
tap.
Yeah, not regular, because when you think about it, they treat that water. They treat it to control the algae. They're not treating it to put in minerals and vitamins and all that. They're trying to control algae and things of this nature. Am I right on that, Joel?
Yes, you sure are. And when we come back, I'll talk about getting out to the community and exercising and walking.
Okay, that sounds real good. We'll be right back.
This show, Your Future Is Now, is sponsored by SpeakersPathway.com. And just like the show, we are dedicated and aligned in perfect harmony with the same vision and mission of helping people to find their future. Is fear holding you back from your calling or your life mission? Do you struggle with taking that first step? If so, Bill Henrich is our catalyst to help you create perspectives with new possibilities that will bring you more peace, more joy, more love in your life and freedom. Do you struggle trying to build your strategy? Do you know how to reach your end results? If not, Gigi Ames is your expert in strategy and helping you create your step-by-step game plan to reach your finish line. For more information on creating the life you want to live, reach out to Bill Henrich. Or if Gigi Ames can help you with building your strategy with your end goal in sight, go to speakerspathway.com. That is speakerspathway.com.
It's words you never heard.
Got a lead foot? According to state troopers, here's what not to do when you get pulled over. Don't be a lachrymous and start crying right away. It doesn't help. But if you're under 20, crying won't be held against you. Don't ask for a break, and don't yell or start any argy-bargy. And one trooper said, if they're going to flirt with me to get out of a ticket, it would probably insult my intelligence. But unfortunately, I don't get hit on all that often. So flirting or being a gill flirt won't work. Did you know that 15% of all drivers get 76% of all traffic tickets? And the odds of winning if you challenge a traffic ticket in court are 1 in 3. So what should you do when you get pulled over for speeding? Be courteous to the officer, and most of all, be honest.
It's words you never heard.
I'm Carolyn Davidson, and you can have fun challenging your words you never heard vocabulary with my free app, Too Funny for Word.
We'll be right back. Welcome back to the radio show, ladies and gentlemen. Your Future Is Now is proudly brought to you by the 6MinuteWebinar.com. And here on the Toganet radio station, we got Mr. Joel Peterson. He's talking about some things that we don't normally like to talk about because it's unpleasant for us. In fact, during the commercial break, we're going to be talking about, you know, some more about suicide, how to prevent that, and how important food is for us and all the things going on there. But we were I was so emotional, I forgot to, you know, ask some questions like what are we going to talk about in this section here. But we're going to roll with the flow. And I'm joined today by the honorary host here on the Toganet radio station, Mr. Bill Heinrich, the author of The 7 Levels of Truth and a man that has a free ebook for you right now called Clarity Has No Story. Just go to these three simple words, myfreebook.me. M as in Mike, E as in Echo. And Mr. Bill, welcome back. And I mean, my goodness gracious, Joel is really opening up some dark doors here. And he's also shedding some light on some things, isn't he, sir?
Well, yeah, Jim. I'm not so sure there's such dark doors, though.
Okay.
This is a subject that most people want to avoid.
Yeah.
Try to avoid. Don't like talking about. But mm-hmm. The truth of the matter is there's quite a movement underway to bring a lot more awareness to it. And Joel's at the forefront of the movement.
He really is.
You know, you're going to be speaking, I think you said, what, this weekend, Joel, at a conference? Is that correct?
Yes.
Uh-huh. What conference is that again?
It's the Congress of Medical Excellence 3.0. It's the American Osteopathic Society of Rheumatic Diseases and the Integrative Health Alliance 49th Annual Conference, and it'll be virtual. And we have a little over 20 doctors that will be speaking on homeopathic, naturopathic, osteopathic, even medical doctor practices and processes in rheumatology, autoimmunity, some of the new stuff, the COVID, and all sorts of health processes.
Well, you can tell Joel is going to be at this conference where a number of doctors are speaking, and that speaks directly to his credibility and the work that he's done to be on the same stage as a group of doctors. And I want to commend you for it, Joel. I know that this is your life, and what a difference you've made for so many people. What are some of the other things that you're doing in the movement? And I'll let you and Jim get back to your conversation. I certainly don't want to detract from that.
No.
Because you were both talking about some really good points. But what are some of the other things that are going on that you're doing to create more awareness this way, Joel?
You know, I started to reach out to our local churches. And I volunteer for a local 501c3, the David J. Draculich Foundation for Freedom of Expression. And she's a Gold Star mother. She lost her son in Afghanistan. And she does art. And she is the lady that saved the art program at the Veterans Administration here in Reno, Nevada. And when I was sick and breaking away from the VA because I was so angry, a Vietnam vet at Tandy Leather mentioned Carrie Fritz, who's a recreational therapist at the VA. And so I went and started to work on some leather. And the following week was when I quote-unquote mastered my mountain. And that's when I stepped another step. And I decided to go back to the VA and work on some leather because of my fellow brothers and sisters that were there. And little did I know, since I'm a co-author now in a best-selling book called Mastering Our Mountains, this was a huge pivotal point for me because I learned about this Tina Draculich and I started to volunteer for her. And I figured if I can volunteer for her, I could volunteer for Dr. Clearfield. So then I started to volunteer for Dr. Clearfield. And then, like Patch Adams, I just started going to the VA and hanging out there and helping people say, hey, this is what I'm learning about medicine. This is the doctor I'm working at. This is what I believe you need to do. And I started to get noticed, and the director of the hospital, Lisa Howard, got word of this, and she came and approached me and said, look, you can't just come onto the grounds and just work here. I've got to sign you up as a volunteer. So she signed me up, and I became a volunteer under the director's office, and I became known as what they call an unaffiliated volunteer. So all this volunteer work started allowing me to branch out into the entrepreneur community, 1 Million Cups, Entrepreneurship Assembly, Entrepreneurship Nevada, SCORE, the Boots to Business Program, the Boots to Business Reboot Program.
Mm-hmm.
And now I just recently graduated the Boots to Business Revenue Readiness Course out of Mississippi
wow.
State University.
Amazing.
And SCORE wants to work with me on getting these processes to these veterans, because most of us don't realize there's almost $100 billion every single year that's allotted for us veterans to do business and to do contracts. And we get certain percentages and advantages to doing this, but we end up giving roughly 60 to 70 billion back because a lot of us are sick and we're not using it. And we don't know about these avenues for us to use this.
Joel, one quick question I want to ask before we forget. You talked about the virtual stage you're going to be on and, you know, the all the doctors there. Is there, how could someone out there watch this stage and you catch you online?
You know, it's, you can look up the Congress. I believe it's the Congress of Medical Excellence.
Okay. Let us do this. You go ahead and look up the virtual stage website, and I will put that in the description of the show. And that way it'll be in the comments, because we'll get this out real quickly and be able to share it. We'll get it uploaded to YouTube, and it'll be in the comments there. We can share that YouTube video to
yes.
a multitude of people. So that's what we'll do, ladies and gentlemen. And
The American Osteopathic Association, if you go on their website, I believe for March 20th, March 21st, they have the Congress of Medical Excellence 3.0, and you can get information there.
Okay, we'll definitely get the websites where it's a, you know, just I'm a point and shoot kind of a guy. Okay, give me something, give me a link, like a point on it, click on it, and I'm in there. You know, that shows why I'm a retired master sergeant. I want things easy peasy.
Correct.
And I tell you, you know, some of the things that you've been sharing with us, you know, your journey. How does it feel when you reach out and you help someone come from the ashes of where you were and you help them down the pathway to where they are now, depending on what they need, starting with good nutrition and all that? But I mean, tell us about the feeling, if you would, sir.
You know, I started to have some coaches and mentors that were saying that I'm afraid of money because I'm not charging. And people at Dr. Clearfield's office know I'm the suicide specialist, especially veterans who come to us. But we had a 25-year-old who Dr. Clearfield got done seeing. And he was sitting out there in our little room after the appointment with Doc. And I could see that he still wasn't quite convinced about Dr. Clearfield's processes. And his mom was with him. Mm-hmm. And he was suicidal and he was sick. And I sat down with him and explained how Doc helped me tremendously to where I barely am ADD or PTSD or depressed or anxious anymore. That most of that stuff got stabilized for the first time in my life. And Jim, I saw this kid, to me, have hope in his eyes. He looked at me like, and his mom could see it too. She saw it too, and she started crying. And
wow.
He had hope. And it was everything. And now he's doing excellent. And we got him. And I walked out of the office that day thinking, wow, that's value. what the money that I made. It was what I was able to accomplish with this youth just by telling him the truth and doing what I love and loving what I do. It was super powerful.
Yeah, you came from the heart on that one there, brother. And, you know, the same is true about people that's being told that they society from all walks of life, they want to label you. You know, you got this problem, you got that problem. And when people start believing it, it becomes a reality in their life because their mind will self-justify why they should believe. And many times it's a lie. We've all been told for decades, because even the medical people did not know that suicide is physical more so than mental. And think of someone who commits suicide, you think, oh, they were really, messed up in the head, when we experienced Mark's suicide, he suffered from chronic traumatic encephalopathy, commonly known as CTE. We all felt guilty. And what we felt, I've got to share this with you. We only got a couple minutes left. But what really is tragic in a situation like that is when people come over, they're afraid to say something.
I know.
It's different if he got killed in a car accident or had a heart attack or died from cancer. But they're afraid they're walking on eggshells.
Yes.
And that's why we need to take a deep breath, relax, look this thing in the eye and say, hey, this is not, we can do something about this. And I want to personally salute you. I want to personally thank you. We're going to be breaking here in just about 30 seconds, but in the next leg, Joel, what do you want to share with the audience, sir?
How to spot someone who's in a
rut. Yeah, that would be huge, because that's the thing that ate me up. Why didn't we recognize the signs? Oh, right. I love that. Mercy. Oh, I might have to fasten my seatbelt on that one there, because I've been there, folks. I know what it's like.
I
can't wait till we get these commercials out of the way, because we'll be right back right after these messages.
Future Is Now is sponsored by SpeakersPathway.com, and just like the show, we are dedicated and aligned in perfect harmony with the same vision and mission of helping people define their future. You may have heard that a picture is worth 1,000 words. Well, a video is worth 1,000 pictures. Koji Somaldi says, if you're not using video in 2019, you're going to get left behind. Most people feel lost or confused when it comes to marketing. Preston Martelli is a marketing guru whose strategies are both art and science in growing your business. Preston helps you make the right decisions that are predictable, measurable, and scalable. For additional information about Koji, Preston, or any of our executive training directors, go to our website at speakerspathway.com. That is speakerspathway.com.
Are you ever afraid to order something at a restaurant because you don't know how to pronounce it? Fox News reported that many people mispronounce common items while ordering. Some of those words that give people trouble are bruschetta, those yummy little slices of bread with chopped tomato, garlic, and olive oil. Chipotle, the pungent red pepper often pickled and eaten as an appetizer or added to meat and stews. Beignet, which is sort of a French donut. And believe it or not, there is no X in espresso. If you ever go into a restaurant and see redonkadonk on the menu, that's a grilled burger with ham, bacon, cheese, egg, and Spam inside two grilled cheese sandwiches made with extra thick Texas toast style bread. Try it. It's delicious.
It's Margin Neighborhood.
I'm Carolyn Davidson, and you can have fun challenging your words you never heard vocabulary with my free app, Too Funny for Word.
And welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Your Future Is Now is proudly brought to you by the good guys at the 6MinuteWebinar.com. That's SIXMinuteWebinar.com. They got a boot camp coming up this weekend. You want to get there. You want to be there. Just go to 6MinuteWebinar.com/bootcamp. And me and Mr. Bill Heinrich are really enjoying this great conversation we got with Joel Peterson. Joel is going to be talking about some of the things that tortures the family members. And I know this from personal experience from losing a loved one in my family. When someone commits suicide, you torture yourself and think, why didn't I see this coming? Joel, what are some of the things that people can look for and do?
You know, since we're changing the perception and belief of suicide, I don't even say commit no more. I say succumb. I see suicide as a cancer. I see it as a sickness. So they succumbed to sickness. They didn't commit something because of just their perception or belief. They were actually physically sick. And when you're physically sick, you have heart palpitations. You have breathing problems. You get cold. You get hot. You get angry. You get moody. And these are the things to look for. You're just not right. Things are just not right. And energy, we feel each other's energy. So usually you feel something wrong with someone, especially in a family. You start to notice things that are off. And you put them to the side. You don't really want to deal with them. And then sometimes we come up with terms like, oh, he or she's just being lazy, or they're just malingering, or they just don't want to work no more. And the subtleties of pain start to increase the more you get depressed, the more anxiety you have. And I say a lot, what causes suicide? People always say depression. So I follow that up and I say, okay, what causes depression? And they don't know the answer. That's where I started to get into food, and I started to get into air, and I started to get into reaching out to your community, reaching out to physical exercise, reaching out to hobbies and groups and organizations. We are the only animals on earth that require each other for existence. So isolation is horrible. And these are one of the things you really have to look at when people don't want to go to a movie no more, or they don't want to talk no more, or they leave from work early, or they stay over when everybody else leaves and goes to the bar or something. They're little keys that you start to look for.
Yeah. I knew a guy that knew of him pretty well, you might say, and we weren't close friends or anything, but his escape that he used, fortunately he didn't commit suicide, but one of the things that he escaped, he looked for ways to stay busy in the office after hours to give him a reason from going home. That was his escape. And he did not realize he was digging himself into a hole,
correct?
You know, personally, you know, not only with his family, but also personally in his mind. And that's a deep, dark shaft, isn't it?
It is. And a lot of us escape. We escape by drugs and alcohol. And especially the youth. No youth wants to just wake up and start drugs. They're usually compensating for hormonal deficiency in some form or manner. Most people they'll search out for downers, or they'll search out for speed, or they'll search out for pain numbing, because they're going to counterbalance what's going on in the body. It's weird how some of us can see this and some don't. So we just think they're a drug addict and they're seeking drugs, but there's a reason they're seeking a specific drug and a specific path. And it's usually countering. If they're seeking speed, it's because they're too slow. If they're seeking slowing down, it's because they're too fast. And these are the balances that the main doctors are not taught to look for. They do old labs, and the newer doctors are now doing newer labs, and with genetic testing and DNA testing, we could even do more now. And you spoke of Dr. Grant. He talks about the energy testing that they now have. They have really wild testing that's coming aboard. But pharmacopoeia is used to making money their way. So people like us and these doctors and DOs and homeopaths and osteopaths and naturopaths, they have to fight an uphill battle. And that's that bridge that I'm working on, bridging that gap.
I hear you. And you know, I've been so involved and wrapped up in this show emotionally, more so than I am in other shows, but I forgot to ask you how people could get in touch with you, your email address, any website you'd like to share with us, please do so.
Yes. I'm known as the professional patient on Facebook. I'm also on LinkedIn and have a Instagram page, and I'm on Twitter. My email is Joel, J-O-E-L, A as in apple, T as in Tom, 67 at gmail.com.
Okay. I'll have all that in the description as well, ladies and gentlemen. And so the professional patient, that is your the name of your all the other pages that you mentioned. Is that correct?
Correct. And or it's under Joel B. Peterson.
Joel B. Yeah. Peterson, that's P-E-T-E-R-S-O-N.
Right.
And I tell you, thank you for sharing that with us, because I normally ask for that a couple of times, and I just got too caught up in it, Bill, because, I mean, you know, goodness gracious, I got a little emotionally caught up in there more so. And I tell you, I'm going to turn the mic over to Bill and give him a chance to give some insight and ask some questions if he likes, sir.
Well, actually, I'm pretty content listening, because the two of you are so well connected to this, and that's what's going to help the audience most. You know, there are shows, people come on, Jim, where I take off a racing with them, and this one is, this is your turn, so go ahead.
Okay. I tell you, you know, one of the things that I want to mention, too, Dr. Grant is real big about water. We're 70, I think he said 73%, the more majority water, okay? And one of the first things that when a person starts getting dehydrated, the first thing that happens to them is that they start getting mentally confused. That is the early signs of heat exhaustion. And I've been around that. So what does that tell the people out there? If you're not drinking enough water, it affects your mind. You start getting mentally confused. And I've seen it happen. It happens, you know, it just, you know, it's evident, because you ask a person a question and they're kind of like they're in a fog, a mental fog. And that's... So what you're talking about, all the wonderful things that you're mentioning about cleaning up your body on the inside, get rid of the toxic waste. Oh, my goodness gracious. You know, share a little bit more about that, if you would, please.
You know, there's a Dr. Alexis Carroll. He's a two-time Nobel Prize winner working at the Rockefeller Institute. And he achieved massive results with chicken cells. They realized that your cell is the foundation for your energy, and your cell needs three things. It needs oxygen, water, and excretion. So when that breaks down, that's where all disease comes from, point blank. So when you keep your water going and your oxygen going, that's why Wim Hof's Iceman breathing process has become so popular, because it works. Dr. Thomas Callan says there's four ways to get sick. One is poisons and toxins. Two is excess food or not enough food. Three is electromagnetic frequencies. That does and can hurt you. And then four is actual injury. So you have to differentiate these four, and your mindset and your energy in connection with your hydration and your food, it's the key. It's the absolute key. I don't know any other way to put it. And that's why eliminating certain dairies and meats and going with juices and fruit drinks that are made up with greens, you know, it's really alkalizing and can be life-saving. And it's a couple of weeks to a month to try something new and see how you feel. You've got the medical medium out there, He talks about medical detox and metal detox, and he's gotten celery juice very popular. So there's many ways to start healing ourselves from the inside out, and hydration is absolutely key, absolutely key. And you can also hydrate yourself by keeping a little temperature gauge and a humidity gauge in your home. Our homes are supposed to be between 30 and 70% humidity. And yeah, mm-hmm. since I'm here in Reno, Nevada, we can have 10 to 16% humidity, and you start to get crustacean, and you start to get dry, your wood dries out, you start to get sinus problems, and these can get you sick. And if you're above 70, usually above 60 or 70, then the funguses or molds can come in. So you have to stay inside that parameter, and that's mm-hmm. that healthy environment. Mm-hmm. These are some of the little keys you can do to stay healthy and get out of your depression, anxiety, and suicidal ideation.
Yeah, you bet. We've been talking about Dr. George Grant a lot, and I just want to share with the folks out there his website. If you go to academyofwellness.com, academyofwellness.com, he's got a lot of information there, and he's got some information you can fill out and evaluate yourself, and I mean, it won't cost you one thin dime.
And I'd like to throw in a plug for Clearfield. Dr.
Sure.
William Clearfield, he's at the Clearfield Medical Group. Clearfield Medical Clinic, that's online, and we specialize in hormones, traumatic brain injury, and aesthetics.
Mm-hmm. And we're just about out of time, and I tell you right now, ladies and gentlemen, because as we went through this show here today, Joel has opened up some doors, and he shined some light, and you know there's probably some people out there that probably need to hear this, just for, people want to eat healthy, they need to know how to detox their body, they need to be aware of things. With the websites that we're giving you here, please share this radio show with others. It's going to be on a YouTube link. The YouTube link is Your Future Is Now on YouTube. And be sure and share that with others, because, everybody would love to be a blessing to someone else. Come from the heart, love yourself, and then you can love others. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful weekend.